Hey guys, it's that time of the month. Top 5 favorite albums for January of 2024. Now, I normally go through chronological order, but funny enough, this list is all made up of albums released on January 26. Go figure. So let's start off with Dimitri, 5 Angry Men, out January 26 on AFM Records. They're running to smoke when the fire is fierce. Oh, pick yourself up, 'cause legends never die. This is the band's 8th studio album. They are a modern metal band, at least that's what I'm calling them. It's nearly impossible to define them under one single genre because they're so versatile, they're so diverse in their influences and then their musical approach. This record has all the right ingredients. When you look at the title of the album, 5 Angry Men, it has a little bit of a Quentin Tarantino vibe to it. You see that same vibe in the artwork. And then when you actually sit down to listen to the record, you're going to find that this is a band that on one hand can create a song that makes you want to party, that makes you want to have a good time, but then they can also create a song that has a historical connection to it and a more of a dark vibe attached to that same story. So they can give you a lot of different versions of themselves. They can create a lot of different versions of their music. The album is not disconnected. It doesn't feel like a compilation. It feels like a record that has a sense of beginning, middle, and end, but it does offer you very different scenarios as you progress down the line, almost as if you were traveling in a train and you're looking outside the window. The train is the same, you're still on the same tracks, but every time you look outside the window, the scenery is different. This record is a little bit built in with that in mind, with that sort of experience in mind. Next we have Lucifer with Lucifer 5, out January 26 on Nuclear Blast. Could you hear me? This is the band's 5th record. They are a classic rock metal band, and this to me is their best album to date. I've always felt, listening to their previous records, that something was missing in order for the album to really feel complete, for the experience to be complete. Either be sound-wise, production-wise, structural-wise, it didn't matter. There was always something that felt like it wasn't really right, that kind of put a little bit of a problem in terms of the whole album being able to reach its full potential. It's not the case with Lucifer 5. Lucifer 5 has a great design, a great structure, outstanding production that really elevates that 70s rock metal vibe that this band creates, and it creates it really well. And then it's more mature in the songwriting and a lot looser and warmer vocally. Their strongest album, both musically and vocally, by far. It's very complete when you have all of these elements pulling you in the same direction, bringing you in, allowing you to immerse yourself in the experience. So to me, this is their best record because it's their more complete album where all the different pieces of their puzzle come together perfectly so you can see what the full picture of Lucifer 5 it's all about. Next we have High Res with Dormant, out January 26 on Napalm Records. This is the band's 2nd studio album. They are a melodic death metal band. And this album opens a lot of doors. And it's a leap forward from their debut record. I felt like their debut record was a safe bet, a safe choice. Sound-wise, this album evolves more in the songwriting aspect of it. It's more guitar-driven, and the guitars have a better construction sound-wise. They sound better all around. And then it's an album that vocally it's super strong as well. I feel like all the ingredients were there on the debut record, but perhaps they didn't take chances. They try to stay safe. They try to stay controlled. They want to showcase what they could do and showcasing it in a way that they didn't feel like something could go wrong. This album, while not going too far away from what the original sound was, it's still a melodic death metal album. It's still high res. I honestly felt like they took a few more chances, and that allows the album to grow and allows the experience to grow, and it allows the band to grow with it. Great record sound wise. I really enjoy the sound on this album. The guitars were in the forefront all the time, super dynamic, heavy, melodic, exactly as you would expect them to be, mixing in elements of old school melodic death metal with more modern elements of melodic death metal, and then with a great vocal performance all around that really ties it all up perfectly. Next we have Vitriol with Suffer and Become, out January 26 on Century Media. This is the band's second studio album, and they are a death metal band, and this record changes everything that you thought about this band. It's still brutal. It's still an extremely brutal and dense record, not easy to digest, and if you're not a fan of brutal death metal, if you're not a fan of death metal, this album would completely go over your head, because I just feel like there's too much there, there's too much texture, there's too much density. But it's an album that when you compare with the debut record, it shows a lot more versatility. It's more atmospheric. It has more ebbs and flows. It has pockets within the album and within the songs where that density of sound dissipates, and you're able to process the tracks a little bit better. Gives you pockets that allows you to digest the song and not just feel overly stuffed by them. It's also an album that has more ebbs and flows all around. It's really well constructed, really well delivered. The density that the album has sound wise does not eliminate the individual characteristics of guitars, drums, and bass. You can still hear those elements. You can still hear what they're doing and what they're adding to the overall big picture of the sound and the experience. But it's just a magnificent album because it brings all the brutality that the debut record had, and then they added this atmosphere and they added all of these other elements, like some technical elements to it. They just made their sound feel like it's growing, that's evolving. Still not a record, like I said earlier, easier to digest, and still not a record for that fan that's on the perimeter of that more brutal side of death metal. But for those that are all engaged by that sort of sound, by that genre, this album definitely showcases how talented this band is and how far they can go. I saw the other day somebody online commenting that they could be the Suffocation of this new generation, and I think that's the best way to describe this band. They are becoming what Suffocation was to my generation. So great compliment to give Vitriol, and this album is outstanding. Brutal death metal record that just feels so big. It just feels overwhelming at times, but in a good sense. Last but definitely not least, actually before the last record, let me give a shout out to Caligula's Horse. Their new record did not make my list, but it's a phenomenal album. I'm not a big prog guy, but I could still enjoy a record that's well crafted and well delivered. So shout out to Caligula's Horse on their new album that came out January 26 as well. But at number 5, I have Any Given Day with Limitless. This album came out January 26 on A Rising Empire. Now, this is the band's fourth studio album. They are a metalcore band. And of all the albums that made my list, this was the first one that I listened to. And the moment that I listened to this record, I knew it was going to be in my top five list, regardless of who else was delivering or releasing a record, I should say, in January. It is a great album by Any Given Day. This is a band that has improved and grown with every single record. And when you look at how well crafted this album is, how dynamic it is, the song construction, the sound, the quality of the sound, well produced but not overly produced, it still has an organic feel to it. It still has an emotional attachment to it, something that this band does really well. So the production, the great quality production behind the album, doesn't neutralize this sort of element that still has a little bit of rawness in it. And you see that rawness perhaps a little bit more in the vocal delivery and the lyrical content and in some elements of the sound, but not in all. But great record all around. I'm not surprised that they continue to release better and better albums. This one is by far their best album to date, because the same thing that I said about Lucifer, I'll say about this, it's their most complete record. When you look at the track listing, you look at the structure, you look at the song composition, you look at the guitar work, the vocals, how everything comes together, production, how everything comes together, it's just perfect. It gives this album that right sound for that genre in this time period. There's nothing else I could have asked from an album like this. It has catchy, hooky choruses, catchy, hooky songs, and that's what you need when you're listening to a metalcore album in 2024 and any given day delivered with Limitless. This is it, my top five favorite albums for January. Hit me up in the comment section. I know there was not a lot of releases this month, first month of the year. It's always like that. Same thing with December. As the year closes, there's also not a lot of releases. But hit me up in the comment section. Let me know what your top five picks are, and I'll see you all at the next video. Take care.